Gender balance is so important because our future absolutely is determined by our success of today, and we have a long way to go.
Women have a lot of potential just as much as men do, and so if you only provide for half the population, you're missing out on half that potential that is out there.
I think one of the best things that Griffith is doing is having a conversation. Without a conversation and talking about the possibilities, the problem, the ways that we can address gender balance, it's very hard to do anything.
Gender balance means equilibrium. It means there's no one dominating group while the other groups are being marginalised.
Having the right people in the right places, having the right conversations.
It means feeling at home and at ease and a sense of belonging because I see diversity around me and I don't feel like an anomaly.
So it's about agency and it's about empowerment as much as being about getting everybody's voices heard.
If 50% of the population is not represented in places where the decisions are being made, in the workplace, in the political arena, in the legal arena, then how can we expect those decisions to be representative of the entirety of our population?
Gender balance has a lot of synergies for me about Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander perspectives as well, that it's more than an equity issue. It's that women bring a certain way of working, there's a certain way of being and a certain way in which we know things as women.
I like to think of it more broadly than gender balance. Gender's one part, but people are different on so many other levels.
We shouldn't just think about gender balance in terms of males and females, but we should think about all genders and how those kinds of interactions are continuing to play out.
When our daughters and our sons have equal opportunities as well as equal confidence to reach out for those opportunities and realise their potential, I think that's what balance would mean for me.
As a woman in the workplace in a fairly male-dominated industry, I find myself behaving like my counterparts and my colleagues. If I had more women around me, that's exciting to think about what else I would be doing or how I would be behaving. That would be more like me.
At this sort of, if you like, smaller part of a much bigger unit of a society, we are demonstrating the value that it can bring to our students, but also to us who work in the university.
We're trying to make it easier for women to support women to succeed at Griffith, and to provide a place for men to help women do that too.
But it's globally women need to gain equality, and I think that the best way to do that is for us to start where we can within our sphere of influence. We do what we can here to gain equality, and then we broaden that out to the rest of the world.
I think it's really trying to reflect the community that we're serving, and I believe we can best do that through appropriate gender representation.
Coming to Griffith and having a much more balanced executive, you can really feel the difference in terms of the way in which the conversation flows, the ways in which you work through issues and decisions are made. So there is a really palpable difference.
And it's that commitment. It's not just a short-term, tick a box kind of thing. It's trying to instill, I guess, a culture whereby that just becomes the norm. So I think that's an amazing reflection on Griffith's efforts on that part. Yeah.
It allows the organisation to be the best organisation it can be. This is not about a special handout for women or for minorities. This is about ensuring that every person makes their very best contribution to the university.